Let's start off using XLOOKUP function correctly. Over in column F, I got a list of employee IDs. I would check to see if there's any duplicates. So I highlighted F2 to F7, home tab, conditional formatting, highlight sales rules, duplicates, hit OK. No duplicates, but if you want to see one, I'm going to hold down control and pull that down. Now would have duplicates, but let me undo and put it back here. With the XLOOKUP over in A2, whenever I have an employee ID typed in, I want to find their first name, last name, and department. You could find just one other field, for example, last name, but I happen to want all three. In B2, I'm going to do XLOOKUP. I'm looking up A2. Where's the lookup array? That is F2 to F7. And the third argument that is also required is what do you want to return? In this example, I'm going to highlight G2 to I7. If I was looking for just the last name, though, I would do H2 to H7. And there is the information. Let's do a quick test over in A2. A3, control, enter. That changed. G3, control, enter. Perfect. G4, control, enter. And I get pound NA. If you don't want pound NA, go to B2. Up in your formula bar, I'm on the if not found argument, and I could put in a blank, or I could even put in not found. There you go. There's a great example of how to use XLOOKUP. One great feature of XLOOKUP, and I have this in my XLOOKUP video, the employee ID is over here in column F, and I'm looking to the right. I could do this with a VLOOKUP, but if my employee ID was over in column J, I could still use XLOOKUP, but I could not use a VLOOKUP. Let's move on and show you XLOOKUP being used incorrectly. Different worksheet. I've already put in employee ID A1 up here, and I'm still looking for all this information. What is different in this example? Hold on, my data got thrown off just a second. There we go. What is different in this example is that we're keeping up with the employee ID and information about the employee, but I'm keeping up with courses that they've taken and the course date. So A1, I'm going to have duplicates in here, same steps. There they are. I'm going to undo that just to prove it. So this data is correct, but I can't use XLOOKUP. If you use XLOOKUP, here's what's going to get. You're going to get. I'm going to do XLOOKUP. I'm looking for cell B1. Where could it be? I1 to I11. And what are you going to return? I happen to want to return all of it. When I press enter, the information I get is correct as far as the first record. But if you notice, when you do XLOOKUP and there's multiple records of A1, I don't get the other records. So this is when you would not want to use XLOOKUP. But one cool thing about XLOOKUP, just so you know, you could do this. Again, up in the formula bar, if not found, I'm not going to use that one. Match mode, exact match is correct. But you have this search mode feature here, and I'm going to do a -1, which is search first to last. And so now, instead of finding the first record, I'm sorry, the -1 is search last to first. I'm finding Excel 2 down here at the bottom. But still, this is not what I want in this example. So let me delete this. A bonus tip, instead of typing in A1, A2, A3, let's do a little bit of data validation here. So I'm in cell B1. Data tab, data validation, data validation. Make this a list. Your source is going to be I2 to I11. Cool feature about data validation. I know I have duplicates in here, but when I hit OK on my data validation, it only shows the record one time, in case you're wondering. But I'm going to stick with A1. So instead of using XLOOKUP because we have duplicates, we want to use Excel's filter function. So I'm going to do equal filter. What is my array? I want to return all of this information. What do you want to include? I want the employee ID, so I highlighted I2 to I11 to equal cell B1. And then I have a third optional argument that says if empty. I don't need that. When I press enter, real quick, just look at this record, A1. Excel 1 on 915 is perfect. A1 PowerPoint on 329 is great. Fix these dates real quick, just highlight them. I'm going to make them a short date, no big deal there. So that's still correct. And then finally, I got another A1 down here on 921. That function is just spilling down right there. So if I come here and change this to A2 in cell B1 on the date of validation, it again is correct right there. Great. So that is when you would use the filter function versus XLOOKUP with your Excel data. Check for duplicates, find out what it is you need to know, and then decide which one of those functions you want to use.